Al-Kiram. Today khutbah is about the hikmah, the wisdom in the Holy Quran. In Alhamdulillah, Nahmadu wa nasta'inu wa nasta'afiru wa nasta'di. And a'udhu billah min shurur anfusina wa min sayyata amalana wa man yahdillahu falam mudirlu lah wa man yudlil falagadiyalah. Wa nashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ahdahu la sharika lah. Wa nashhadu anna sayyidina Muhammadan abdahu wa rasuluh. Amma ba'd. Yaqdil giram. My brothers and sisters in Islam, the Holy Quran, the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is full of wisdom and hikmah. Wisdom called hikmah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in many times, in the Holy Quran, us encouraged and advised us to use wisdom in any matter of the life, especially when we read the Holy Quran, the story of the Quran, and the verses. Many examples in the Holy Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Inna anzalnahu Qur'anan Arabiyan la'allakum ta'qilun." We send the Quran, we send it, reveal it in Arabic, perhaps you show wisdom. "Inna ja'alna Qur'anan Arabiyan la'allakum ta'qilun." Verily, we caused to be Arabic, the Quran. Perhaps you be wise. "Kadhalika yubayyinu Allahu lakum al-ayatihi la'allakum ta'qilun." In this way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in this way, Allah makes clear to you His message so that you might show wisdom. Ya Akhwat al-Kiram, brothers and sisters in Islam, we should grow wisdom from all the stories of the Holy Quran, from all the full wisdom and understanding. Many stories, the story of Yusuf, Joseph, Ibrahim, Ismail, Adam, Solomon, David, Lut, Yahya, Yunus, Zannun, and all prophets. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my brothers and sisters, wasn't a storyteller. Quran is not a storyteller, folklore. These are Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to get the wisdom. ذَٰلَكُمْ وَسَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. We give advice to you, perhaps you show wisdom. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us much of advice through the Holy Quran. "Inna anzalna ilaykum al-kitab and fihi dhikrukum afala ta'qilun." We send the kitab for you, want you to use wisdom. "Qad bayyana lakum al-ayati la'allakum ta'qilun." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you know, all from the hadith, Surah Al-Hadith, from the Surah Al-Baqarah, and all. "We have indeed made our message clear to you," Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "so that you might use your reasoning and wisdom." Ya Akhwat al-Muslimin, so much wisdom is in the Holy Quran that Allah called it, the Quran, called it Hakim. تِلْكَ آيَاتُ الْكِتَابِ الْحَكِيمِ يَاسِين وَالْقُرْآنِ الْحَكِيمِ. See? And this is the Qur'an full of wisdom. But as I said, if we learn and act upon this, what he says, and use it, we never go wrong in anything. وَيُعَلَّمُمُ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحِكْمَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is working. And teach you revelation, knowledge, and wisdom. This is a wisdom come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wisdom come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يُعْتِي الْحِكْمَةَ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يُعْتِي الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوْتِي خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. See what he said? He said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, granting wisdom to whom He wills, and whoever is granted the wisdom, has indeed been granted the abundant wealth by Allah. My brothers and sisters, from Imam Ahmad radiallahu anhu, that recorded Ibn Mas'ud says, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, two kind of people we have to envy. One, a person is rich. That is like this. A person who is rich and spend forever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Spend all his money or portion or whatever for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, this one we should have. and a person who has a wisdom and do just and justice between the people and teach the people wisdom. These two, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you should aim. And of course, there are so many wisdoms in there. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was saying a story of the in his time, actually, a story of the two women which they came to the Suleiman alayhi salam. There are two babies. One baby was eaten by the wolf. Another one said, "Is mine." Another one said, "Is mine." One said, "Is mine." One said, "Is mine." He said, "No, it's mine." And they were fighting. And it came to Suleiman, Suleiman alayhi salam, King Suleiman. So King Suleiman said, "Bring me sword to cut it off." The woman who lost his baby and he knew, he said, "Okay, give me half. No problem." And the other woman says, "No. No, it's my baby. Give it to her. I want Shibila." And from the wisdom of the Suleiman alayhi salam, they finally says, "Is this really?" They knew. It is that the person that you give away is. Because he says, the first person in Islam who got the hikmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, learned the hikmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, was Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know what? لَغَدْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَغَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمَنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهُمْ رَسُولًا مِنْ أَنْفُسِهِمْ يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابُ وَالْحِكْمَةَ. Now I tell you, of course, many brothers does not know the meaning of the English. I tell you, otherwise I know many brothers understand it. Indeed, God bestowed a favor upon believers when he raised one apostle from amongst himself to convey his message unto them and to cause them to grow in purity, knowledge and wisdom. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, take the wisdom from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and give it to the people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, especially udu ila sabil rabbik bil hikmati wal mu'idati al hasana. Very Call all mankind unto your sustainer's path with wisdom and goodly exhortation. And again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Min. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ حِكْمَةً أَنْ أَشْكُرِ لِلَّهِ وَمَنْ يَشْكُرْ فَإِنَّمَا يَشْكُرُ لِنَفْسِهِ وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنِ الْعَالَمِينَ. غَنِيٌّ حَمِيدٌ. And indeed, we grant wisdom to the Luqman to praise to Allah. And if anyone prays to Allah, he prays for his nafs. My brothers and sisters in Islam, many times in the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the kitab and hikmah to give. Kitab, this means the two are intertwined, related to each other. يُعَلِّمُكُمُ الْكِتَابِ وَالْحِكَمِ. Therefore, the learning and understanding of the Quran bring wisdom. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was alive, he was teaching the people in the way he was pleased, as he was the real teacher of the Holy Quran. Quran revealed to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But when he left, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam left, he made sure that Quran been collected and written in the way that Quran be a teacher and be guided to whole mankind from the start to the end. The start to the end, 140 chapters. Brothers and sisters, Quran is not like a book which is written by man or will come in index and whatever. It's different. And when the revelation of the Quran came, is arranged in a different way. Because first time when the Quran came to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, revealed, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. You know, very famous. اقرأ سورة الألق. اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. But why didn't put him in a start? A start of the Holy Quran. اقرأ بسم ربك. You know, through the while he revealed to us, there is a hikmah. There is a big, great wisdom in this. Why the Gabriel told the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to arrange it in this way? He didn't read it himself. Gabriel, is there a hadith? I see the wisdom, of course, many ask why and how, and many scholars give opinion on that. I see the wisdom in arranging this. It's got sense. You look at it. Arranging the chapter in this way, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from the start to make it clear to all readers, Muslim and non-Muslim, how they should act and who is in charge of the universe, the world. Because he says, anyone who reads the Holy Quran, Muslim and non-Muslim, atheist, give homage, give respect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ashallah. He give respect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you read in Surah Al-Fatah, for example, I'm atheist, I'm reading the Surah Al-Fatah. I did it in English, of course, you know the Arabic. In the name of Allah, the compassionate, the merciful, I am a benedictine, say. All praise be to Allah. I'm respecting. Lord of the world. I'm admitting He is the Lord of the world. The compassionate, the merciful, I'm showing His grace. How merciful is that? Ruler of the day of the reckoning, I'm giving Him the ownership of the world. Ownership of the day of the judgment. I mean, you alone we worship, and you alone we ask for help. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, here, you know, it's the biggest story of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent that surah, made it two part, one part to praise Allah, and one part for the people. It's not enough time to talk about it. Now, the atheists say this one, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the, you know, metaphorically, for the help and guidance. Guide us to a straight path. As he says, the path, those who have received your grace, Allah. And after that says, Amen. That's it. You can see that. You can see it as a meditator asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance. Therefore, بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن الكريم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الذكر وآية الحكيم أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات واستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى والدين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, one can see that immediately following this chapter of the Fatiha, Surah Al-Fatiha, which is one of the heaviest surah in the Holy Quran, one of the strongest surah. Surah Al-Baqarah, the perfect cow, the cows or the perfect cow, Al-Baqarah. Why they praise there? Surah Al-Fatiha had nothing to do with that. It didn't come after the Surah Al-Fatiha. There were long years before than that, or after than that, they came. Then why are they doing that? What is the hikmah? What is the wisdom behind it? And I tell you, why he places that? It is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this surah is straightforward. Start by starting who can or cannot benefit from the Holy Quran. Allah knows best. Allah knows. Who can or cannot? You can read it. From the start, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala divide the people in two groups. Two groups. One who wants to improve. One who wants to be muttaqin. And obey. And one who does not listen, do not want to be obeyed, and wants to be against others. And what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says after it? Alif lam. ذلك الكتاب ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين. Without a doubt, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says himself, without a doubt, in this book, guidance for the mutaqin. Without a doubt, this guidance. In general, it's continuously clearly explained who are the God-fearer, mutaqin. Mutaqin, God-fearer, respecting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the way they deserve. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, there is a sixth condition, six attributes, my brother, is very important. Many people read the Quran 100 times, many Hafiz read 100 times, or other Hafiz, they don't understand why they're talking about it. See if it makes sense. Sixth position. Six people have possessed six attributes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون. Simple, very simple. I said in English for the brother Bashir, don't understand. Those who have iman بالغيب, the common conditions, the people who perform daily prayer, those who give in charity, those who believe what sent to you Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, subhanahu wa ta'ala, doesn't say Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I say Muhammad, and what is revealed to them before you, they have to believe, and truly, and those who truly believe in the day of judgment, then Allah said those people are the truly muttaqeen, God fearer, and guided to the straight path by Allah subhanahu. So very simply said, very simply, it denotes who is good for. In fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states that these are conditions that one should, these are, if you look at it in this way, conditions that one should possess if one wants to understand the Holy Quran and the Holy Quran God. ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. Muttaqin, they got six conditions. If you want to learn without, you know, if you want the Quran guide you have to have six conditions. By Allah, and by the word of Allah, there is no doubt about it. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without a doubt, that is, these conditions are the key to understanding and guideline to the Quran. Oh, brothers and sisters, however, the good news is, if you haven't got, you can gain. Through the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you haven't got six, I haven't got six, I don't pray much, I don't do that, I don't do that, I don't do that, I didn't read. You can, by the mercy of Allah, all we can do it. And again, the other ones are, of course, coming. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْهِمْ أَنذَرْتُهُمْ أَمْ لَمْ تُنذِرْهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sealing. Those are kafirs, right? خَتَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَى قُلُوبِهِمْ وَعَلَى سَمْعِهِمْ الْأَخَرِ. Ears, eyes, everything been sealed. قُلُوبِهِمْ sealed, I sealed them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, hey, no. Therefore, you see, my brothers and sisters, by putting this chapter as a second chapter, clearly mention who can get benefit from the Holy Quran. There is no surah in the Holy Quran which you can explain from the start, explain that. No surah, you look at it. Here, clearly says. And you can see, it makes sense. Brothers and sisters, let's talk about the wisdom of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Great wisdom, great man of Allah, great prophet. A man said to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Ya Rasulullah, I want to be one of the rich people. What did Rasulullah say? He said, he replied, be content with what you have, and you'll be rich. Another man said, Ya Rasulullah, I want to be just. And the Holy Prophet said, like for your Muslim brother what you like for yourself. Word of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A man said, I want to be one of the best people. Ya Rasulullah, show me. And the Holy Prophet replied, be beneficial to the people, you will become one of the best among them. And the man said, I want to be one of the special close servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, replied, remember Allah as much as you can and you will be close to Him. As-sabiqun, as-sabiqun, ulaika al-muqarribun. And again a man says, the last one, I know you're getting tired now. And a man says, one, on the day of the judgment, Ya Rasulullah, on the day of the judgment, I want to be under the mercy of Allah. What a beautiful thing to have. And the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, be merciful to the creation and Allah will be merciful to you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to gain these six attributes and teaches us the knowledge and wisdom of Holy Quran and the Sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ameen. ونسخ الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل محمد إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة برحمتك يا رب العالمين. آمين آمين. أقام الصلاة.